is Category 3 storm, 115 mile per hour gust winds to 138, 217 miles to the east-southeast of Melbourne, Florida. Again, now moving more so off towards the north, northwest, and eventually kind of turning closer towards the Carolina coastline. All right, let's go on and see what we have here as far as, again, the track of Irene. As, again, we advance this forward, we're going to be talking about the storm making the move, still a Category 3 storm. Again, this is the new advisory now from the National Hurricane Center. So by 2 o'clock Saturday, it's just getting very close to the Carolina coastline here, still a Category 2 hurricane. Then it, from there, it continues to move on northward. And in fact, again, the close-up track is going to show that by now it's a Category 1 storm Sunday afternoon at 2 o'clock, somewhere the center located in the central portion here of New Jersey. Again, we're not going to pay particularly as to where the exact center makes its move because this is going to be a large storm, so the effects will be ranging far outward from the center. Look at that track, just almost across New York City. If that happens, we have not had a direct track of a hurricane on top of New York City since the early to mid 1800s. So just to give you an idea how rare this possibility is, but that could also produce a storm surge in New York City, which is also a rarity that will occur. So let's talk about the wind speed surrounding the storm. Again, potentially we're talking about in this orange band here, winds of greater than 35 miles per hour. Notice how large that extends. This is 2 o'clock Sunday, and these would be the hurricane potential winds, 65, 70 mile per hour plus winds in that red band that you saw. So what you can expect here, the worst from the storm, again, Saturday night through Sunday, heavy rain, at least 5 to 10 inches of rain. The storm surge will be Sunday afternoon if it indeed does come true on that track, with the high tide being Sunday evening. So this could be another complicating factor to that storm surge with that high tide. Winds 75 miles per hour greater, 60 miles either side of the center, 35 mile per hour winds of 200 miles outside of the center. Many trees are going to fall. Expect a lot of power outages. They could last for days. Okay, remember what happened with Ernesto a couple of years back, where the power outages lasted for a long time. Highest wind gusts will be east of the center. The less wind to the west of the center, the heavy rainfall will cause flooding well inland, even up into the Catskills, even into northwestern Connecticut. So be prepared for that. Now, let's talk about the storm surge potentially on the track, which may even now be a little further west. I did this graphic about an hour ago, and again, you can see a potential 4 to 10 foot storm surge if it indeed comes true right along the area here along the south shore of Long Island, even in towards southern Connecticut, and even into the lower portions of New York Harbor, into the lower portions of Manhattan, for that matter. Now, the secondary storm surge is something we have to watch, again, with this type of a track, because after the storm passes, the water will actually come back down from Long Island Sound towards the East River. So that could flood the North Shore here, as you talk about Throgs Neck to about Willits Point, and again, to the eastern sections of potentially Manhattan, not necessarily flooding there, but a potential for, again, a what we call a secondary storm surge. So